I spent a month learning the basics of Pekiti Tertiakali. To be specific, I learned the PTTA curriculum through Pekiti University. In this video, I'll be talking about my experience and what I thought about this online course. So just to set some context, my current membership with Pekiti University is the Gold membership, which includes the course material of Silver membership alongside this. But for the most part of this 1 month journey, I really mostly stuck with the beginner levels in the Silver membership and browsed and tried some of the stuff in the latter levels. I think one of the perks of self-directed training is that I can tweak the experience a bit and see and experiment what might work for me.
But in my opinion, the lessons are chunked, spaced, and sized nicely. No single video felt too long. In fact, the course doesn't actually immediately give you access to every single video at the start. The lessons trickle in each week until you have complete access,
which I think helps pace yourself to prevent being overwhelmed by all the information.
I also found that the instructors taught in a very concise and straightforward manner. This approach was effective for me as I got the stuff faster, and when I didn't, it wasn't such a bother to just rewatch the video. From the limited experience I've had with the course, it gives me the impression that footwork is heavily emphasized in this style. In fact, watching sparring tactics alongside this course helped me appreciate that observation. The course starts with footwork and I was immediately challenged. I had to unwire some of the automatic movements I already do and recalibrate my strikes and footwork to the PTK way of things.
But I enjoyed this challenge a lot.
To be honest though, I have Tenelle to thank for helping me digest some of the mechanics. She's a lot better at processing new movements than I am because my body tends to want to just do what it already knows how to do.
And quite frankly, footwork isn't the most exciting thing for me to learn.
Although different styles of FMA would have their own unique flavors, there's always bound to be similarities. Some of the patterns and movements I tried here were very similar to what I experienced trying different things. And I had to nudge myself not to automatically do the variation I already carried with me.
Unwiring what I already know and rewiring something similar yet different was a really fun learning challenge for me, and it allowed me to expand my physical vocabulary of movements.
One of the things I really appreciated in this course is how it allowed me to further expand my options and motions when it comes to my FMA practice. I've actually noticed some of the PTK stuff creep into my carenzas and free flows, especially in the footwork. As someone who identifies more as an explorer these days rather than a specialized fighter or athlete, this approach I'm pursuing of increasing my overall fluency across different languages of FMA has been quite fulfilling, especially when I'm able to notice the fruits of my labor.
And I think it's quite useful for me personally to have some basic knowledge of different styles and systems, given the path I'm pursuing as a content creator trying to advocate for FMA as a whole rather than just one style or system.
For the most part of this 1 month journey, I did this in the form of solo training, which meant that some of the forms and drills that required a partner were given limited time. But as I mentioned, Tenelle did try some stuff with me once in a while, which I highly appreciated. Because of this though, I can say that a beginner who might come into this course may face some hurdles in learning this system on their own. Although I was okay with skipping some of the partner stuff since I'm taking this all in casually, I think it would be a good idea for a beginner to find someone they can work on the course material with to fully maximize their experience.
But having said that, I think it's totally possible to learn on your own and to explore the material here, so long as you're willing to acknowledge the limitations of training solo. So that was my experience with this course. I'll put a link in the description box if you want to try it out. Also, a quick shout out to my Patreon supporters for helping me produce these videos. If you want to support this channel, I share behind the scenes videos and extra vlogs on my Patreon page. So I'll put a link to that in the description box below as well. Keep training, keep learning, keep exploring, and I'll see you in the next video.